Hey, what is up, everybody? This is Stevie Breach coming to you here today. I can honestly tell you that this is a video that I am not excited to make for the one reason of I'm not looking forward to getting my ass kicked or my ass handed to me on Sunday. I will say that I do have Patriot fans as friends, good old Phil, good old Justin. I know that they are probably looking forward to Sunday and licking their chops. I can honestly tell you that when my 49ers were good and my 49ers played a bad team, such as the Patriots playing the 49ers this week, I honestly didn't really mind skipping the game. I knew that there are times when good teams do not show up against bad teams, and all of a sudden bad teams come out and they surprise somebody. I mean, honestly, when you look at this year's schedule for the San Francisco 49ers, the Patriots game is honestly their Super Bowl. They are not going to play a better team than the Patriots. They already have one win against the Rams, and I know it doesn't make a lot of sense for the team to go all in on this game. We're going to give everything we got on this game against the Patriots, but I think that honestly sometimes teams do that. I mean, if you think about the Warriors, I can't remember if they tied or if they beat the Bulls record for the most wins in a season. In the end, it doesn't matter because the Warriors lost. They lost their 3-1 lead in the finals to the Cavs, so they didn't get it done. A lot like when the Patriots went undefeated throughout their regular season and then they lost in the Super Bowl that year. A lot of times people will give them the regular season record, but when it comes down to saying who is the better team, you got to give it to the team that won the championship. I don't know. I can see the Niners going all in on this game, but I still don't think the Niners are going to be able to compete against the Patriots. No way in the world I think that this is going to be able to get done. The Niners, they were able to show heart last week. That was something that I wanted them to do. They lost 23-20 to the Cardinals, and it is what it is. You know, they were able to get back at it. They got the Pats, and that's that bad card to draw. Tom Brady has been killing it this year. I remember back to 2012. I think that was Kaepernick's rookie season, the year the Niners went to the Super Bowl. The Niners had a big-time Sunday night football game. They were playing in New England, I'm pretty sure, in Foxborough. The Niners won 41-34. That was the same night, I believe, as TLC. And I had more people tune in and watch my video about the 49ers and the Patriots than my TLC review, because they knew how ecstatic I was going to be that the 49ers actually got a win against the Pats, a game that I really didn't think that they were going to be able to do. That team was stocked with, Colin Kaepernick, Frank Gore. Crabtree was still on the team at that time. People were thinking that Michael James was going to be a star. Harbaugh was the coach. Akers was the kicker. That was a damn good football team. Defense was stocked. Carlos Rogers, Patrick Willis. I can remember more of those guys then than I can remember who's on the team now. It's a bad place to be in. Niners aren't going to win this game. There's no good way to put it. I was glad to see that Carlos Hyde was back out on the football field last week. 13 rushes for 15 yards. That's not good. We're going to demand more from that if we're even going to be able to compete in this game. Colin Kaepernick was able to rush the ball. But when Colin Kaepernick is your leading rusher, it's very rarely that you're going to be able to win football games. You're going to be able to win games like when he ran for 200 yards against the Packers in that playoff game, but that's few and far between. Your main running back, Carlos Hyde, has to be leading the charge. That way you can set up the offense for Patton to actually start catching some footballs and the passing yards start coming out of the arm of Colin Kaepernick. So, here's to it. Worst case scenario is that the Patriots bus gets lost on the way to the stadium. And they do the Dumb and Dumber, and they drive back home instead of driving to Levi's Stadium. But that's probably not going to happen, and the Pats are going to kill them. So we'll see you on Sunday. We'll talk about the game and see what happens.